Obama could be going to prison for years after his sickest money funnel yet was just exposed. For the past 8 years, Barack Hussein Obama did everything in his power to destroy our country by dividing Americans along political, racial, and economic lines. After taking sledgehammer to our country and our Constitution, Obama then gave America one final parting gift in the final days of his presidency, where he secretly funneled billions of dollars to radical left-wing activist groups. As domestic terror groups have rapidly risen to power thanks to Obama, an investigative journalist is now revealing the other sickening thing Obama did during his last days at the White House that will leave you furious. According to a bombshell report published on Tuesday, the Washington Free Beacon revealed how Obama and members of his Justice Department schemed up a way to get extra cash sent straight to radical leftist groups of their choosing. Whenever they'd get any extra cash from settlement cases, they'd simply funnel it into the pockets of leftist radicals, who are now serving as the militant wing of Obama's shadow government. Dennis Michael Lynch reports. In August 2014, the Justice Department settled a case against Bank of America for $17 billion. Other settlements made in penalty cases against J.P. Morgan Chase and Citigroup brought the total windfall of cash to $36.65 billion. In some settlement cases, companies had to pay their penalties direct to nonprofits in the form of donations, instead of giving the money directly to the U.S. Treasury. According to the Free Beacon report, documents and emails obtained shows that people within the Justice Department influenced where the slush fund money was routed to, and conservative groups were not on their list. Nonprofits approved for donations included UNIDOS U.S., previously known as the National Council of LARISA, NeighborWorks America, and the National Urban League, all who support left-leaning community organizing groups. The Free Beacon detailed additional unbelievable facts regarding this latest Obama scandal, revealing how there was a push for making donations to these leftist radical groups mandatory in all future settlements, the documents show. They reported. Leaders from outside groups also spoke to Peter Kotsick, the former Assistant Attorney General for Legislative Affairs, in March 2014 to push for making donations mandatory in all future settlements, the documents show. Months later, the Justice Department announced the bank settlements would include mandatory donations to community groups. This would additionally offer enhanced credit for the donations. I'm sorry to be a pest. We keep tinkering with the settlement agreement and I want to make sure we are doing it right, Elizabeth Taylor, then the Principal Deputy Associate Attorney General, wrote in a November 6, 2013 email. Can you explain to Tony the best way to allocate some money to an organization of our choosing? She later added, referring to Associate Attorney General Tony West. Email documents are provided below detailing correspondence within the Justice Department regarding the redirecting of settlement funds to the community groups. Eric Holder was U.S. Attorney General from 2009 through 2015. Could you imagine the backlash if a Republican president was funneling money to domestic terrorists? As we're learning of our tax dollars being placed straight in the hands of domestic terrorists like Antifa, Obama's silence following the Las Vegas massacre has been extremely unsettling given the rumors of what was found in the shooter's hotel room. Inside sources within the FBI hostage rescue team that day are now revealing that they found Antifa propaganda littered throughout the hotel room. An unfortunate fact for Obama, who was busted by congressional investigators several months ago for funding radical left-leaning groups. Obama's Benghazi partner in crime, Hillary Clinton, has blood on her hands too, as she was busted for giving Antifa terrorists around $800,000, although liberal fact-checkers like Snopes will try and deny this as the truth. Being that Obama is tied to these radical leftist groups, the fact that an Antifa member might have successfully pulled off the largest massacre in U.S. history is extremely unsettling. With the mainstream media doing everything in their power to censor the truth, it's up to Americans to help spread the truth about what's really going on, as Obama stages his political comeback this fall.